Very exciting times for the Gambia. Maybe you could just set the scene and tell us a little bit about what's going on.
Gambia's petroleum sector is, in today at its, best, I could say. We recently, signed an exploration license with BP through a very open, transparent, and competitive bidding round that, lasted for over 2 years. And BP is set to drill a well offshore, deep offshore well, within the next 2 years. In addition to that, we've had our first deep offshore exploration well, in the last 40 years, last year, December, around October, drilled by FAR and Petronas. So there are exciting, things going on in exploration in the Gambia.
Sure. Yeah. And you've got a number of blocks currently unlicensed and two ultra-deep water blocks in the process of being demarcated.
Yeah.
How quickly do you think you might be able to sort of sign these up to companies and start seeing some progress?
Yeah, in total we have 8 exploration blocks, 2 onshore, 6 offshore. 3 have been licensed, 5 are to be licensed. So, we want to undertake some more seismic over those 5 blocks, or at least 3 of the blocks, that is the 3 offshore blocks, in addition to the demarcation and further seismic acquisition of the ultra deep areas. Once that process, data acquisition process, is completed, new licensing round would be initiated. This is in recognition of the importance of data in the bidding process.
Sure.
Yeah.
There's been some questions about companies expressing preference for direct negotiations over license rounds.
Yeah.
Why do you favor a license round process?
License as a government with assets to put on the market, you want the best value for the assets or the blocks, and in order to get that, competition is the most appropriate approach to getting the best value for the blocks. We have done it, and it worked. We got one of the best companies in the world in a small country and relatively unknown. Oil industry like the Gambia. So we believe it worked, and it's the approach to go. At least for the most, prospective blocks, bidding round would be the preferred, route.
True.
There are other blocks that we may, or we would be open to direct negotiation. It depends on the prospectivity, the subsurface knowledge, and availability of data on a particular block, which will determine the approach that we will adapt.
Sure. Mm-hmm. Another thing that companies have expressed interest in is the question of sort of fiscal stability and regulatory certainty. Mm-hmm. Can the Gambia offer this?
Indeed. This is one of the most important, lessons we've also learned through this licensing process. Our engagements with the various IOCs have all opened our eyes to, their expectations, and also has broadened our understanding of the realities of the industry today. Some of them you have just, put your finger on, namely stability of the fiscal regimes. This is one thing. Not only are we going to provide stability, but we want to make amendments to our fiscal legislation to bring it to industry standards. And we are doing this using international law firms very familiar with the industry, who will not only look at what government wants, but who will also know what the IOCs expect and what's fair for both the government and the IOCs or the industry. Yeah, so we can certainly, I mean, assure and provide fiscal stability and predictability, fiscal and legislative stability and predictability.
Sure. So the you're obviously in a very attractive postcode at the moment with the SNE developments in Tortue. Is presumably you're hoping to find similar prospects in your offshore? Is it a similar sort of geology?
Yeah, I mean, like I said in my presentation, the Gambia lies right in the middle of the MSGBC. MSGBC, to the north, you have the Tortue, you have the SNE, to the south, you have the dump floor. It's one of the most prolific, I mean, exploration areas today on the continent. I mean, there had been proven petroleum systems. I mean, confirmed source rocks. In fact, numerous source rocks. I mean, different types of clays, stratigraphic, structural, I mean, prograde, I mean, carbonate salts, a wide range of, I mean, play types. You have the salt domes, I mean, towards in the south. So we are very confident that we will find oil in the Gambia.
Fantastic. And if there was one thing that you would say to companies sort of looking at the Gambia and other areas, what would that message be?
That message would be very simple. We have or are putting in place the right structures, legislations, processes, and institutions needed by the industry to undertake petroleum exploration. So the Gambia is the place to be.
So we're here at the Africa E&P Summit, and maybe you could just tell us a little bit about who you've seen here and what you've gained from the event.
Yeah, Africa E&P, we are coming here for the first time, but it's been amazing. I mean, the types of meetings we had, the profiles of companies. I mean, you come here and you meet everybody or everyone that you need to meet in the industry. We've had meetings with FAR, we've had meetings with ExxonMobil, we've had meetings with BP, we've had, meetings or number of meetings with other geophysical service providers such as TGS. We've also met on the sidelines with Tulo. So, I mean, you come here to see anyone that you want to meet, come to Africa E&P. So I promise I'll be here next year.